Let's figure out the derivative of x to the negative 3 power together. So in the past, we learned the power rule, but we only at that time said that we knew it applied to positive integers. So in other words, we've learned so far how to take the derivative of things like x to the fifth, which would be 5x to the fourth. So we want to see if maybe this power rule can be applied to negative exponents as well, like in this case, x to the negative 3. And, you know, if there's a form for that type of derivative. And the way we're going to do that is, once again, by using the quotient rule. So let me remind you of the formula for the quotient rule. It looks like this. The derivative with respect to x of the quotient f of x divided by g of x equals g of x f prime of x minus f of x g prime of x all over g of x squared. So let's see if we can apply that to x to the negative 3. Now, first of all, currently this isn't set up as a quotient. But if we remember the rules of exponents, that we can make a negative exponent positive by moving it to the denominator, then we can easily express x to the negative 3 as a quotient. And if we do that, it's going to look like this. 1 over x cubed. Okay, so the derivative with respect to x of 1 over x cubed is what we want to find. And now that I have it written like this, it's easy to see that the quotient rule does apply in this situation. So let's apply it. So g times f prime of x, or bottom times the derivative of the top. So bottom times the derivative of the top, so that's x cubed times the derivative of 1, minus the top times the derivative of the bottom. So minus 1 times the derivative of x cubed, and that's all over the bottom squared. So quantity x cubed squared. So let's work out that numerator. So we have x cubed. Now the derivative of 1 with respect to x is 0. Minus 1 times the derivative with respect to x of x cubed. So now on that we can use the power rule. We have a positive integer exponent. So that's going to become 3x squared. And then on the bottom, I have x cubed squared. Now remember, another important rule of exponents is that when you have a power raised to a power, you combine those by multiplying the powers. So x cubed quantity squared is x to the sixth. So let's continue to simplify this. So x cubed times 0 is just 0. So on the top, I'm left with negative 3x squared. And on the bottom, I'm left with x to the sixth. So I can reduce this. I have two factors of x in the top and six factors of x in the denominator. So if I simplify, that leaves me with four factors of x in the denominator. So I get negative 3 over x to the fourth. Now, if I want to, I can also write this as negative 3x to the negative 4 by bringing that x back up to the numerator. So what have we just discovered? We've discovered that the derivative of x to the negative 3 equals negative 3x to the negative 4. So remember, in doing this problem, we were kind of trying to see if we could maybe find a rule a power rule for negative exponents, essentially. And what we see here is that the power rule we know previously, which looks like this, actually seems to apply for negative exponents as well. Because I had x to the negative 3, I have the negative 3 out front, and then I have x to the negative 4, which is the previous power reduced by 1. Now, of course, this isn't a proof in itself, but it's good evidence. But in fact, you can prove that the power rule does apply to negative exponents.